Hello, this is George Lees. I'm trying to play the Inhale soundtrack because I've got this whole solution to the corrupted Metropolitan Police, and I want to include this in video number 4 about the massive Freemasonic listings. I'm going to tell you this story first. This is Telly Savalas, who is surprisingly part of the Jack the Ripper story. Yeah, as it now stand, and every second day on the media, Prince Harry has a new girlfriend. Yet I've explained to you why Pippa Middleton was his girlfriend. I've explained to you why the woman that sings "How Long Will I Love You" was his girlfriend, and her name is not Telly, but her name is Ellie Goulding. And this one is the one who we left off with on yesterday's story. Let me show you him again. He's the Salvation Army. Yet all the religious connotations of Rothschild's being in charge of the whole world. Okay, and he's got all of the regalia that could have him in the Masons, but not the medals, because they're not allowed to do that when you love your neighbour. Okay, let me explain to you Telly Savalas' role in life and in those massive Freemasonic jokes. He is likely to be in King Herod's bloodline, and let me show you who else is in that and for how long. Okay, so there is the Ripper tab that I'm now going to take you to. Remember the name of that one? He played Herod in the religious movies, and I'm going to show you that he's a Jew and he's in the Roman court when they write the Bible. Ripper tab, okay, there it is. Sir Charles Warren is the corrupted policeman who was the Metropolitan Police Inspector. Yet he went to Palestine and he engaged in archaeological digs to find out about King Herod's temple. There is the bloodline, albeit from the man that is totally defamed by everybody now, but this is the world's ancient truths. There is Cleopatra the Seventh. Yet there is Arsinoe, for the Arsinoe jokes that I keep telling you. And there is King Herod the Great, married to another one of the Mariam M&M characters, way before you get down to Arius, Antoninus, Calpurnius, Piso, alias Josephus, the man on the golf course for Donald Trump, who won the election last night, because Hillary's not allowed to win it, because every American president has to be a Freemason, like Sir Charles Warren in the case of Jack the Ripper. Yeah, let me show you his tab. I found it this morning on Peripheral Masons. There he is, nice looking guy. Bilbo's actor plays his role. This is Charles Warren, born in Bangor in Wales, educated at Sandhurst like a military man, ends up being the boss at the Met Police. As an agent of the Palestine Exploration Fund in 1867, he surveyed Herod's temple. Conducting excavations in Jerusalem, recording his discoveries in two books, The Temple, the name of the lodge, or The Tomb Under Jerusalem, The Holy Lands, and all of the Masonic jokes since we possibly never ever went there, and the treasure was never ever found. And this is the links to John Buchan and the Grand Lodge members that are in charge of Canada, which is the listing for this Freemason. He's on the Canadian lodges. And that takes you further down into the earliest academic prizes I ever won, writing about the battles at Quebec. And he's also one of the leading Freemasons. That is the Wolffe characters. Sir Charles was London Metropolitan Police Commissioner from March 1886 to November the 7th, 1888, when we went to Khartoum. He resigned in conflict with the Home Secretary, Henry Matthews, earlier on the day that Mary Jane Ann Kelly, yeah, the massive name in World Mobsters, that's another role for the man Jagger that we explained yesterday, being in the swastika brigade, because Jagir means hunter in Germany. The last Whitechapel murder victim ascribed to Jack the Ripper was found killed with their fannies cut out. It's personal. He is warning us that he understands, says Johnny Depp in the Jack the Ripper in Hell movie, that this is about cutting out the pie piso pie, which is the vagina in translation from Italian. Okay, let me now take you further down the tab and show you all of the current day culprits. And this is what I got from the Met Police this morning when I went to their website and tried to look at these historical characters. Sorry, we are unable to deliver the content you are looking for. Please try again later. That's why they insisted on me using the cookies, so that they could find out who else was into the joke that the Freemasons share. The content Met Police UK page is not working today. Yeah, Met Police site history. Yeah, openly declaring that they are the mafia, which are the Piso Polis, since the Pisos yet launched the joke about cutting the fanny out, which is the pie, yeah, pie Piso translation in Italian. And you've got the case here because it makes them look like legends in the Freemasons. The Ripper murders and the Whitechapel murders right next to the Bank of England. And there is Johnny Depp, the one who's going through all those traumas. He was on rehab, yeah, after the Twin Towers were brought down. He was married to the woman that played the actor's role in the Twin Towers movie. He's now divorced from her. He's now divorced from the new woman that he's affiliated with. And there is Kojak, Telly Savalas. And I'm having terrible troubles with my Kodak camera. Yeah, from Hemel Hempstead. And there is Jane Paige, or Joanne Paige, who is the woman that played the lover of the royal that was actually the Jack the Ripper murderer, Prince Eddie, not Edward the Seventh this time, who's the murderer of the legitimate kings in the Windsor bloodline, and that one plays his boss in the Met Police. Yeah, and let's keep going down, and there is the woman that is the actress, and her name is the same as the politician, yet that believes that the monarchy is not necessary. That he is looking at the Grapville evidence that this is the Windsor family that have committed the crime, and all the Harry Potter jokes are in it. Yeah, and the only person who's prepared to solve it is me, because I now drink coffee, a stimulant like the absinthe that he uses to get his inspirational ideas about who the culprits are. Let me show you who was the one who played that Warren guy, who is the police chief, yeah, that insists that Joanna Page, there she is after she's had her lobotomy, yeah, and that is a visit from Inspector Johnny Depp. Okay, and she's still got her fanny cut out, but the policeman that we've not yet showed you, who is Warren, is the one who cut her frontal lobes out with a massive ice pick through the cranium. All part of the cover for the illegitimacy of the British royals ever since they came from Hanover. And there's Johnny Depp and all these women, and he's now in desperate straits. You can see the stress in every photo nowadays. Yeah, every photo. Yeah, ever so embittered that someone could find them out, and he's a pirate of the Caribbean. There's Joanna Page, she's lovely. There are no pictures of her now, unless you look at the thing that I was trying to play there, which is the Jack the Ripper in Hell number one, the trailer for the movie, and you'll see her sitting on Prince Eddie's loins. Yeah, and there are pictures of her getting married to the same actor, because they are the people that play the roles of Gavin and Stacy, and their surname is Shipman, and you know all about the Shipman covers. She's a beautiful woman, but what she has on her conscience now must be a massive burden. There is the policeman, yeah, who is actually the same as the aristos that were the prime minister in this country. His name is they are Home, yet his name is Home. Yet, like Sir Alec and all of the crimes that they've committed in that river of blood that is the Nile and the Garden of Eden. So here's Prince Harry with all his lovers. There's Ellie Goulding. There, he's now dating a woman because Merkel is Hitler's daughter by artificial insemination. Yeah, and I believe that Nicola Sturgeon will be created the same way. She's a dead ringer for the people that are Merkel. Okay, there. So every time, yeah, in the newspapers yesterday is whinging about being harassed by people like us, and this is the killing of everybody in his armies in all those holy lands that are still Freemasonic jokes. And his Freemasonic ancestors are the most evil of the lot. They are the stammering Windsors, George the Sixth. Yeah, the master mason that took the world into World War II for a fucking belly laugh. Yeah, got the Christian cross and the Rotary Club icons everywhere, and the baldric for the time team. Right then. So today he is dating now the Merkel woman. Yeah, because Merkel, she's actually Markel. Yeah, she's a dead ringer for Pippa Middleton too. And every time he changes his story, he was whinging about the Cressida woman that he was dating after they covered up Cressida Dick blowing up the London Underground as part of the MI6, MI5 and London Met Police scams to demonise the Islamic bombers in that town, like the Islamic bombers in Boston and the Islamic bombers in the 9/11 scandal that the British royals actually participated in as full members, with the woman, the redhead, that his auntie, yeah, or maybe it's his auntie, yeah, that is Prince Andrew's partner, who is Fergie, and all of the Fergie jokes gets their tits out. He's had his willy pictured by Berlusconi, who's a Mason, but has been chucked out because he does bad things, yeah, while he's still allowed 30 years beyond him doing those bad things and being chucked out the Masons of the Celtic region in Italy, yet he's still allowed to be the Prime Minister until they replace him with the totally unelected Rense, who is the cover for Jeff Rense, who's another innocent and honest analyst on how the big oil companies are defrauded by people like Donald, who's now the president without ever declaring those conflicts of interest, that he's on the ExxonMobil board and he's on the board for Royal Dutch Shell. And this one's a dead ringer for the Ferdinand people that live with the Rothschilds in that massive mansion. Yeah, and the Rothschilds are intertwined with the Merkels too, and that is the Schuckel Berg jokes, and that is the Shoemaker jokes for the Warner Brothers. Okay, let's take you back to the list of Masons and start again. This is episode 4 now, M to 7, M to Z, and there is Telly Savalas, King Herod, yet likely to be in the same bloodline ever since. Yeah, all of them know their bloodlines and they're ever so guilty now. Every one of the rich list members, this one's just a commonplace actor and part of the Jesus joke. Yeah. Who loves Yah? Do you get it? Everything is a biblical joke because these are the fathers of the biblical fraud. Yeah, and he's the one that killed the fake Jesus. This one is in the Christian Salvation Armies, and maybe they can get their reputation back. I need to get a move on today. I'll only show you the pictures. There he goes, David Sawyer, and the covers for the Sawyer, and so only pictures today. There is the Freemasonic Sun God icons for Ra, yeah, and all of the people with the Masonic symbols that are part of the swastika series, and you've seen the Sun God and how that links to the swastika and the Rotary Club, yeah, and the Probus Club and all the capitalists across our world. Shira Seddon was born in Eccleston, yeah, the Duke of Westminster's patch. St Helens, Lancashire, became New Zealand's longest serving Prime Minister. Okay, that is Seddon. We're still on Shira here. Walter Marty Wally, an astronaut. Yeah, let's get rid of him. Yeah, do you see it? Every one of the Governor Generals in Canada and all the colonies are massive unelected power brokers. Yeah, like the woman that declared that Mr. Bean was the war correspondent. Okay, this one's much more important. That's another Gemini and Apollo joke. Yeah, about replacing the gods by going up in the spacecraft. They never are able to do that. Yeah, and all the numbers are Freemasonic. Okay, and there is one of Scotland's most evil men. I believe he's related to my relatives, the Rayburns. They came forward, the Hoyk branch, in my last few days in my hometown. Yeah, they're the relatives of the Scots of Hoyk, like my ex-boss, who is now in the Australian Outback, who was the dean at Otago University when they booted me out. Yeah, and the Burns boss in Otago University is Helen Nicholson's husband. Yeah, and she's the woman that said, before I became the head of the best department in our school, that she'd like to merge with me because we were the smallest departments, and when she saw that I was the best player in their team, they needed to get rid of me for reputational reasons. So you have a departmental review and out you go. This is Walter Scott that writes the Ivanhoe story, that an Ivan is the name of my favourite standoff in rugby, who's got a disabled child, and it is the name of David Cameron's child. Yeah, and David Cameron's prepared to steal from his country, and he was Camerinus in the Roman court when King Herod was there. Yeah, Walter Scott, the massive monument, and all the Rob Roy treason, and the Ivanhoe stories about freedom fighters in the woods. Yeah, the know-nothings story right through world history. Thank you to the Rayburns for confessing. Scott, Sir Walter, 1771 to 1831, was born in Edinburgh, and among many novels, creator of Ivanhoe and Rob Roy. Yeah, that's about the rapes and all of the people that are involved, and that is Archie, the treasonous one with the sword that is prepared to kill Rob Roy in the fight. And that is played, the role of Rob Roy is played by Liam Neeson. And all of the Scottish women get shafted and raped, and all of it is out of St David Lodge, number 36, in Edinburgh, was Sir Walter's Scots Lodge. Not as great in the rankings as Robbie Burns. Yeah. Seddon, Richard John, this is the one that is the born in Eccleston, like the Duke of Westminster, and all the ecclesiastical jokes of the Goon Show members. They think they're too clever for any one of the readers to understand that. There's the Goon Show members. Yeah. Eccles in the cast, like the Duke of Westminster, it's no surprise that he died really young. He runs the British Legion and sells the poppies on the Sunday that we're now coming towards again. Yeah, so Seddon is the Grand Master of the New Zealand Lodge, 1898 to 1900. Yeah, and he lived to 1906 because God caught up with him, died in his 50s. Yeah, the boss of the subsidiary that is New Zealand in the Commonwealth for the Queen, and there are the Goons, Sellers, yeah, the father, fathered by Lord Mountbatten in that massive estate on the Test Valley, where all of the money, the drug launderers that worked with Prince Philip came from, that is Porchester and Plunket. Yet the Test and Itchen Valleys, the most elite fisheries in the trout world. Yeah, and these ones are out and out jokers. Harry Seacombe, Peter Sellers and Spike Milligan. The heroes for my father-in-law. Yeah, Ted Hancocks from the fucking Rotary Club. Yeah, with the sun god chains hanging round his neck. Okay, Peter Henry, and these are the famous Masons. All of them, yeah. Sellers was the one who played the role of Marcos Manoel, and that is the film Being There with Peter Sellers in it, and that is the killing of Greg Hallett, who told the world those stories, and the illegitimacy of Bill Clinton, yeah, who is the son of Winston Churchill. Yeah, they were in yesterday's lists, the Churchills. Okay? The Goons, the ecclesiastical killings through all of world history. Yeah, and Eccleston in Formula One, and all of it is eternally attempts to cover up the horrible truth that they get to be world owners and monarchs by killing their citizens again and again and again. Here's this one. Yeah, you must have realised that yesterday I cottoned on to the fact that the pictures come above the declaration. This is Shackleton, who botched his campaign to find the South Pole in the heroic Antarctic exploration out of New Zealand that they already own. Yeah, Sir Ernest Henry Shackleton. The movies and the films make you cry. Yeah, Lyttelton Harbour, New Zealand. Those are the harbours that Putin sank the ships in. Yeah, the sinking of the, I forget what it's called, it's all over my website, on Greg Hallett, a death threatened species. Yeah, in 1908, departed from Littleton Harbour and botched his campaign, and he ended up in Antarctica on rowing boats home, so it looks ever so romantic. Yeah, and you can cover up the whole of World War One with it. Yeah, 1874, and died on those expeditions in foreign lands in 1922. A hero for the people that died or survived the Great War. Yeah, isn't it lovely how we run it? Shackleton, Leonard Francis Lane, another one. Yeah, was an English footballer in the post-war two period. Lived right up to 2000. Right then, and this one is an unknown. He's got one of the swastika icons, yeah, for his, it could be the Iron Cross, yeah, or it could be the Victoria Cross. Scott Robert Falcon, another one of the frozen failures, yeah, and all of the Scott lineages and cover as we get today for the financial crimes and the declarations that the bloodline are out. They now get the ordinary people, thanks to Gav Brooks on the fascist list for our country, for pointing at those Scots drinking in the same pub as John Lamont, MSP. And he is de Lamont, and that comes into the story further down. Okay, and he is out of Oamaru in New Zealand, and that is where I met Rab Nisbet in New Zealand. Oh no, I met him in Dunedin Airport, but Oamaru is where he made the movie about the pirates that were Sir Robert Louis Stevenson's story about Treasure Islands. Yeah, and all of them still have been stolen by the Queen and her male relatives, and that's why Hillary's not allowed to be president, because every one of the presidents has to be a Mason. Service, Robert William, there's one in my town that I'm very fond of. I was in love with his daughter. He died really old. Yeah, and he had his babies really old. But this is a different one, born in Pai Pai Piso, Preston, with the word Piso in it. Yeah, in the English county of Lancashire, of Scottish parents, Bobby Service actually made his name as a Canadian poet. After emigrating there in 1895, he was called the Bard of Yukon. Okay, let's get the pictures going, because I've got a whole quarter of the story to tell. Russell Simpson, Gertrude Simpson, actor Russell Simpson's Masonically engraved gravestone is actually a McCaskill in the middle name. Yeah, don't know what the sinister story is this. It will just be a cover, I believe, for Mrs. Simpson being the massive bitch that allowed the family to pretend that they were lovable people and that they were not in love with sexual deviance, because Mrs. Simpson was a hermaphrodite and she loved to have sex from both ends. Right then, so here we go. And this one has got his picture, and he is Richard Bernard Red Skelton on Radio Cinnamon and TV from 1937 until 1971. While all the time he pursued an entirely separate career as a fine artist. Smith, Joseph Smith, founder of the Church of Latter-day Saints, which still has got the links to the massive man that was a presidential candidate and was foreign secretary when they went to Vietnam. Forget his name. The founder of the Church of Latter-day Saints. He's in the bloodline that is also takes you to the Bushes and to the Nixons, and his name is, well, I've made loads of videos on it, and he's all over the Latter-day Saints transcript, but I can't remember his name at the moment. Smith, John Stafford Smith, born in Gloucestershire, England. But there's another picture. This is Admiral Nelson, I think. Oh no, Admiral Sir Sidney Smith, the man that made me miss my destiny. Lovely romantic pictures and beautiful uniforms, yeah, until God gets them in those conflicts. Reminiscing later in his life, Napoleon Bonaparte said of this man, Admiral Sir Sidney Smith, that man made me miss my destiny. Yeah, the naval Rule Britannia's on the Azure Main for Rothschild. Yeah, the Royal Society of London. Yeah, he was knighted by King William IV. Yeah, that's the Hanoverian kings again, the sons of mad King George. Yeah, and the relatives of David Cameron and Boris Johnson. Bastards. Yeah, royal bastards. It's a really good thumbnail I created for that video on Boris Johnson and Cameron and why they've had to resign. If you ever hear a rousing military march, yeah, like the Azure Main song, it was written by American composer John Philip Sousa. Okay, with the swastika and the rotary icons everywhere and the fanny that is the Alpha to Omega sign with the prick in it. Yeah, I would be prepared to fight this one in single-handed combat too. He's got a fez-like hat on for the Allied forces. Yeah, everything is a joke about their ancestry and the killing of the innocents through all of world history to music that becomes opera. Yeah, and is sung in the fucking Albert Hall like the Azure Main song. Spanos Alexander Gus Spanos, of Greek descent, of San Diego's Chargers professional football team. Yeah, that's a different set of football rules in America to Britain. This could be the drug designer, but it is Sir Bernard Spilsbury, and that is the launch of the Pillsbury Doughboys in 1960, and they have massive links to the Skull and Bones people. Yeah, because they are an evil, evil family, and you can see the links to the Piso family in the spelling of that word. Okay, a leading British pathologist whose groundbreaking work solved many devious murders, Johnny Depp. Yeah. And the Grappas, who are the Windsors of Grapfield. Okay, Spilsbury, Sir Bernard. Let's see who the next picture is. because we're still a long way off. It's another spaceman. I'll totally ignore him when I've told you his name. Thomas Stafford received the highest award in aeronautics, the Wright Brothers Memorial Trophy. The joke about fly right and keep straight on. As a fascist in all the great for-profit conflicts and all the false moonshots. Okay, and there's the planes that they train in the Right Stuff movie. Lieutenant General Stafford involved in initiating F-11-7A stealth fighters, and these are the people that did for Vietnam and all of the subsequent conflicts in the Holy Lands for the Bush family. Two generations of them, and one of them has got the word poppy in his middle name, because that is the joke about Poppea in the Roman court being married to Nero when he was murdered by the Piso family that faked the Bible and tell you to love your neighbour globally. Right then, this one is Frederick Arthur Stanley, 6th Governor General of Canada. That may not be the Stanleys that wandered round the world looking for David Livingstone. Yeah, and he is in the hockey, ice hockey sector that Putin now gets demonised in as a full member of their team, and another one who persecuted New Zealand. This one has no photos, but he used to be my favourite football man. Jockstein, I used to have his autograph, but like all of my chattels, they will be thrown out of my house, or more likely sold in the corrupted charitable sector, like all of the contents of my house and my children's chattels before my wife left me. Yeah, all of it is the same repeating story, that why do we need a railway network unless we can rip it up and start again? Yet the whole of the lives of the Hancocks' ancestors were doing that out of Chester, right next to Eccleston. Jockstein died in 1985 in a Scottish qualifier, and he was the boss at Hibernian Football Club as well. Yeah, the Steen name is a giveaway of where he comes from and what his affiliation is to. Yeah, and that is all the Celtic regions of Northern Italy and Cis Italy and Transalpine. Yeah, and that is the McAlpine jokes. And it is, sadly, the devil's actor that is, I forget his name, he was Al Pacino. Isn't it funny? Al Pacino, a member of the Royal Society, another New Zealand. William Stukeley was an English antiquarian. Here we've got Newton, of whom he was a friend, and that is the physicists who become the Rutherfords and invent the nuclear bomb that we use for Japan, with the help of the Oppenheimers on the financial services boards in the corrupted Houses of Parliament in Britain. Name now Hodge for reputational reasons. Harry Stutz became a roaring success with a car that roared in the 20s right to the present day, the Stutz Bearcat Formula One speed guys. Okay, another picture. Simon Bolivar is not pictured. Wonder who this one is. It's got the Masons and the Bankers bowler hat, or top hat for the magicians of our world. Composer Arthur Sullivan, and this is the Gilbert and Sullivan piss artists. Yeah, pirates of the pirates of the Penzance. Yeah, same families ever since the Roman court was launched, and launched them into the Mafia. Grand Organist of United Grand Lodge of England. Ugly. Yeah, run by Churchill, run by the Stammering King, and all of it is the same fucking pie HMS Pinafore jokes. Okay. Petrovich Jonathan Swift, the author of Gulliver's Travels, the story about the giants being in the heavens and we need to get rid of them and replace them by Jesus. Switzer, yeah, my persecutor in NHS Scotland, Basil Switzer, has a Masonic family. Switzer was an American child actor, professional dog breeder, that's the god when you read it backwards in Hebrew, and hunting guide, most notable for appearing in our Gang short subjects series as Alfalfa, one of the series' most popular and best remembered. Basil Switzer, relatives maybe? Yeah. Enforced drug medication for the most innocent man on the globe, who's a professor of neuroscience and understands totally why the whole of psychiatry has been launched to silence the people and even the lovers of Prince Eddie in the prostitution dens who get the lobotomies because they are a menace to that massive Windsor family that is the Saxe-Coburgs. Taft, William Howard, 27th president, got to be a Freemason. It's on the list. T. Richard Longstreet was a war hero and Medal of Honor winner. Here's another photo. Who is he? The IDs come below the photos. Yeah, Thomas Telford was a jovious, pioneering engineer and Mason who built over 27 bridges, many of them in Bristol, where they launder all of the money through those Bristol boiler rooms, yet with the affiliations to the massive trading of the slaves out of Bristol and out of Liverpool, all of it run by the Walter Scott families and the Dukes of Northumberland in both of those massive cities, thousands of miles from their vast tracts of land, sorry, hundreds of miles. Okay, no pictures, let's keep going. Sylvanus Thayer, Thomas Telford, David Thomas. Okay, and Thomas Telford, born in Dumfriesshire, like those world-owning bloodlines, self-taught civil engineer, architect, and stonemason. Isn't it funny? And the Masons have been hit by a cemetery stone, and it's killed a little child in the false news that we get in Scotland this week, the NBC. Okay? And the cops in that case are accused of neglect. That's the Piso Polis. Lowell Thomas is chiefly remembered as this is Lowell Jackson Thomas, famous American reporter who immortalized British soldier Colonel T.E. Lawrence as Lawrence of Arabia. Oh, I thought that was a man. Oh no, that's the other African stories. Yeah, so this is the man who chased him around the desert looking for heroic stories to write about how the British advise on stealing everybody else's countries, even the people, yeah, where they invented writing and they faked up the Bible out of Canaan. Yeah, Lawrence of Arabia, killed on the TT motorbike, Thornhill, Thorvaldsen, yeah, all the jokes about the sun god and the gods of Norway, yet replaced by politicians and artists in Scotland. William Hogarth was one of Thornhill's students. Thorvaldsen, Carl Albert Bertel, born in Copenhagen, where they used the swastika for the Carlsberg beer companies. Yeah, right then. And this one's got lovely satanic beard. Who is he? Get a move on. His name is Germany's High Seas Fleet Could Never Defeat Britain's Grand Fleet. Grand Admiral von Tai Tai Tirpitz advocated unrestricted U-boat warfare in 1917 when the Time Team and Blackadder's team thought the war was over in the trenches for a belly laugh. Right then, more pictures. Here's another one. Looks like the Academy of War in America. Yeah, the commander of the Texian defenders of the Alamo, Colonel William Travis. The cover that the Travises are in the Paris, Texas movie. They're a pop band and revolutionaries in Scotland until I suss them out, and they are the inquest people that make the decisions in Nuremberg to kill the body doubles, yeah, and to let the other people go away to the colonies in Latin America and run the narcotics trading, yeah, with all of the world leaders like the Roosevelt family. Travis Colonel William Barrett was a Texian leader in the Battle of Alamo, and that is the Texas jokes about them fighting against the Mexicans who still use the piso currency. Crockett, David Crockett. Here's another comedian. Yeah, probably in no great conflict. Tommy Trinder was best-loved actor from the late 1930s through to the 1960s. Yeah, you know what happened in the late 1930s, don't you? Known to millions of depressed Britons, especially during the Second World War, as Tommy Trinder, this English comedian helped the British people laugh their way out of the stammering King's War. Yeah, all the people in the pinstripe suits working for the War Office are massive profiteers. Yeah, he lived and was able to be on telly right up to 1986. Tommy Trinder's immodest cast phrase is, "You lucky people, you are not over there dying in the trenches." Trollope Anthony, he's the one that visited Waddesdon Manor with the Rothschilds, and this is the one I got wrong yesterday, because he is actually the one that partitioned Palestine. Yeah, that's where Telly Savalas went, and his relatives went there. Yeah, as the ancestors. Yeah, here is Harry Truman, gave the order to drop the atomic bombs that finally ended the Second World War. Launched by the rocket scientists and nuclear physicists out of Göttingen and Heidelberg that were immune from bombing, like Oxford, Cambridge, Bedfordshire, and all of the places that de Gaulle and the people from cowardly regions went to, yeah, so that they could live peacefully through the war. And the British king abdicated to Paris in the opposite direction, but is still perfectly safe because the whole war was run by them. Yet, for profit, as Masons, and the leading Masons in our world, this one got £2 million to sell Palestine to Israel. Franklin Delano Roosevelt, above, became the 33rd President of the United States. Truman did, following the death of FDR. Yeah, that's God took him out when he demonized Stalin. You know all of those stories already. Here's Mark Twain at the bottom. His real name is not Twain, it's Clemens, and that's why Winston Churchill in the bath sings the Clementine song for the Orangeman. Yeah, we're getting down, we might get to the bottom of the alphabet. Okay, Voltaire. Aruet Francis Marie Vivanake Swami, born Narendranath Dutta, Swami Vikankanda, was a Hindu spiritual leader. He is considered a key figure in the introduction of philosophies of Vedanta, which is now a massive financial crime, reported by Gordon Bowden and Peter Eyre, involving David Cameron's Cairn companies. Yeah, and the selling of the same busted shares to the Indian nations. Okay, and this is Voltaire, I believe, in 1694 to 1778, is part of the French Revolution and the French Renaissance, for a laugh. Yeah. Musée Carnaval, yeah, from the Alps, and that is Mark Carney, from Carnival in the Alps. Yeah, no pictures. Here's another Wade of Quebec. Wagner, Sidney Wagner, John Mayhew Wainwright. Yeah, that is the hee-haw joke in my favourite film, that the Wainwrights are the plane magnets and they build aeroplanes. Yeah, and they send the people to their deaths, but Bailey's brother comes back as a war hero. Yeah, and the Wainwrights fund the revival of George Bailey and his buffoonish uncle, who loses all of their money in the only place in the town that is prepared to build affordable homes for the poor people that have gone to the war and to their deaths. Jonathan Wainwright was actually a US Army general in the Pai Pai Philippines during the Jap invasion in 1941. Having fought at Bataan, he surrendered Corregidor on the interest of preventing further loss of life, but it was a decision that haunted him all of his remaining life. So he's not the hero in the war in that movie, as it's portrayed, but he was awarded the Medal of Honour in 1945 when he had sold it. Everything you believe is a lie, and that is the FBI boss, who's Edgar Hoover further up, and he's on that 19 list with the Jack the Ripper copper, yet that I found this morning. And it's ever so interesting because the Thompson newspaper magnates are on that list too. Yeah, the Merkel story has gotten them all, yet with their ears pricked up. Yeah, and look at the likeness between Merkel and Nicola Sturgeon. I cannot find her genealogy and the links of the Sturgeons to the Sturgeon in America is a schnapper, and in New Zealand is a schnapper, and schnapper Rothschild is the head of that bloodline that sired Hitler Rothschild through the Schickelsberg woman, the Schuckelberg woman from the Rothschild mansion. Yet you can find all of those stories now on the internet from several sources, including mine and Greg Hallett's. Yeah, and they come with really embarrassing pictures for Merkel, who I lobbied for all of that time. Rick Wakeman gives much of his time helping charitable organisations such as the UK children's charity Sparks. Yet this is the decrepit people that God dismembers in childbirth, yeah, or through acts of God, or they're actually the victims of the corrupted government, which is why David Cameron is now out of office. Okay, George Corley Wallace, governor of Alabama. There's a metro go. Oh no, let's get to the Warner Brothers really quick. Yeah, this the Krasnoselk thing is a huge joke. That's where they come from. Okay, I'm going to take you there now and ignore the rest of it. I've got, oh no, we've got loads of time. 48 minutes I've logged. We normally get 80. Ward. First, okay, let's just do the, oh no, there's Ben-Hur. Need to tell you that. A tale of Christ in inverted commas. Wallace Lewis Lou, unfairly maligned for poor decision making during the American, okay, he's got a picture. And it's Ben-Hur. It's not the one that I thought it was. I thought it was El Cid. Yeah, it's Ben-Hur. This is another joke about the Lion of Judah, and the actor Charlton Heston, my greatest hero, playing the man who is the slave, yeah, in Egypt. Okay, Wallace Lewis Lou the Mason, all of them, all through all of those religions that are a cause of the world's ancient strife, are on the take in the lodge. Ward John, first Viscount Dudley and Ward. Right then, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of England in 1742 to 1743, 2 years before Culloden. Yeah, and here's a pinstripe guy, and it's a Warner. Okay, this is it. We're into Poland and the death camps and the killing of all of their neighbours in Krasnoselk within days of them being shipped out to avoid the Panzer Regiment from Hitler Rothschild's Anschluss in the death camp region of Poland that became Treblinka. Krasnoselk, yeah, and it is the region that is the joke about the goose woman that is in all the fairy tales and the folk tales about the fox leading her along, and that is that because these guys end up it's not Gertrude the goose, it is the really gullible Yorkshire tales, and it is Jemima. Yet the carving up of the regions in Poland are into regions called Jemina. Yeah, do you get it? That is Jemima Puddle Duck and her being led into being killed, yeah, as an innocent woman who's very constructive about laying her eggs and looking after her children. Yeah, that's why the Warner Brothers went to America to look after their children, because they knew that everybody in that hometown of Krasnoselk, which means Rothschild silk, Yeah, the silk factories that they have in Wadsden and at Windmill Hill are making silk stockings for the French profiteers. Yeah, do you get it? The Warners are the Fox News, and the Fox is in the Jemima Puddle Duck, and the Jemima carve-ups are just the same as the 100-acre carve-ups on the other side of Europe. Yeah, and the numbers of people in the town of Krasnoselk came down from 3,500 within a week of that Panzer regiment passing through, all of them killed in the death camps. And if you look up Krasnoselk, you'll see that they have memorials to all of the people that were killed, so the Warners, as their neighbours, could not be recognised as the major propagandists in America. They also, in the film that is Jumanji, they are Jews. They are escaped out of that Jewish place, and they are then allowed to run a shoe factory for a laugh. Yeah, like the woman that is the mother of Adolf Hitler, the Schuckelberg shoe factory joke, and the Schusters of Holland. Yeah, son of a shoemaker, and that's the Pinocchio joke that we told you about in the video yesterday. Along with his three brothers, Albert, Sam and Jack, Harry Warner from Krasnoselk played a crucial role in the development of Warner Brothers, and that is the all the goose stepping jokes and all the menagerie that I told you about yesterday, and the declarations by Ali G that Barbara Bush and the Hanna-Barbera menagerie of Muppet characters are more dangerous than anything that George W. Bush or his dad Herbert Poppy, yeah, the Roman presence in the court at that time, yeah, were able to declare that, yeah, the cartoon characters for the propagandists are now much more dangerous even than the murderous presidents that took us into Iraq several times in several generations, and all of the weapons are sold by these people, and all of the covers become the cartoons. Warner, Harry Morris, Hirsch, Moses, Wonsal. This is the identity of Jeff Worrell. Yeah, it's a tiny little change in the name. He's the one that hangs his head in my hometown of Kelso every time I mention Krasnoselk, and his name is Worrell, a rugby playing mate of mine. Born to Jewish parentage in Krasnoselk, a village near Warsaw, Poland, his father Benjamin, some say Wonsko Laser, yeah, changed the Yiddish sounding family names to anglicised versions, yeah, upon his arrival in New York in 1888, when our armies from Britain arrived in Khartoum, led by Charlton Heston in the movie, and that is to kill the Mad Mahdi there, and he is a Shriner, yeah, like all of the people that we've mentioned, like the Ataturk in Gallipoli. Yeah, all of them Masons, some of them Jews, many of them Christians, some of them in the Indian religions, with Lord McCartney of Liverpool, and the Muhammad Ali joke in the religious frauds out of the massive empire of Freemasons that we have created. Okay, so along with his brothers Albert, Jack and Sam, Harry Warner started the motion picture studio Warner Brothers. It's the launch of Fox News for Jemima Puddle Duck and the fox that plans to eat her and all of the fruits of her eggs that she's too busy to sit on. Harry, a renowned penny pincher, was often at odds with his more adventurous sibling Sam, and when Sam Warner proposed adding sound to movies, Harry famously barked, "Who the hell wants to hear actors talk?" Harry Warner was a member of Mount Olive Lodge, number 506, California. Forget what Mount Olive is famous for. Olive oil is legendary, and it's legendary because of the virgin stories that end up in the Bible. Okay, and he's got the rabbit ears in his folded handkerchief, yeah, that is still part of the jokes when Mr. Bean launched the London Olympics with the hanky Yeah, and his eternal need to blow away and wipe away the tears for all of the genocides that he committed, even on a Sunday for Putnam in that case. Yeah, though his business ethic was unscrupulous, with a career spanning 45 years, Jack Warner was the president and ultimate driving force behind Warner Brothers Film Studios and the Jumanji film and the Sons of a Shoemaker joke for Pinocchio, the boy who is Jesus with no strings so he cannot get home. And he's Pinocchio in the movies that all of them make. Yeah? And Fox News is totally evil. Yeah, all of the people that I've written to for all of my time there, they understand the PISO fraud, and that is George W. Bush's private secretary with the lovely ankles. She's like me, a little bit stammery. Her name is Dana Perino. Yeah, and she lived in Homer Simpson's hometown, where Ponzi was the first Ponzi scamster to do pyramid selling of financial frauds in America. And he's out of the mafia in Italy too. These lot are Polish death camps escapees, and it's really lucky that no one has ever exposed them up to now. They now issue the Oscars to all of the war criminals in the jokes. Yeah, that is Steve McQueen winning the Oscar and the cover for Steve McQueen in The Great Escape. He's a Negro, and he danced and hopped like a rabbit with the Oscar in his hands when he won the film, the Oscar. I think it was for the film called the film about the tiger on the boats, and it, all of it is a joke about the genocide in that war that this lot made the propaganda for. Okay, Jack Leonard was born in the town of London in Canada, the youngest, certainly the most ambitious of the four filmmaking Warner Brothers. Could be the Godfather story, could it? Following the untimely death of his brother Sam, Jack Warner was often at difference with his two surviving brothers, Albert and Harry. In July 1956, he manipulated a sale of company stock that saw his brothers unknowingly sell their shares indirectly to him, and thus he became president and controller of Warner Brothers Entertainment Incorporated. That's the stammering king laughing at the war dead in World War II as they were allowed to escape. And just to let them know, it's us as a stammer on the W for Windsor and Warner, and WE for Madonna, who's actually a Ciccio from the mafia in Sicily. Okay, and there's another brother. It's just absolutely evil. Sam Warner, given name Shmuel Wonsol Cliff Worrell. Yeah, Shmuel Smeagol in the Lord of the Rings joke, this slimy little character, yeah, that has to be watched in case he stabs anyone in the back, because he's in the inner circle and he's had the ring for several years and he wants it back from the innocent owners that are played by the actor that is the Jack the Ripper policeman. Yeah, the jazz singer and the all of the launch of Al Jolson, also from Poland, into the jokes about America being down the Swanee now that the Europeans have entirely taken it over and they're still paying their taxes to Queen Elizabeth II, right into the 2040s, and Greg Hallett told me that and was killed for it all. Warren Sir Charles, yeah, this is not the copper. Royal Engineer, English, oh, it is the copper. English archaeologist and the London Met police chief in charge of the unsuccessful Jack the Ripper story in 1888, when we were in Khartoum on the River of Blood. Yet that is the same story as cutting the fannies out in the Jack the Ripper River of Blood from the Pi Pi Piso vagina. Charles Warren, earlier in his life, had organised archaeological digs in New Jerusalem, and in surveying King Harold's temple, ushered in an age of biblical archaeology. Yeah, you've got a double ration there, yeah. Warren Joseph, this physician and American Revolutionary General, was killed at the Battle of Bunker Hill. Here's another president. with the trowel for the cornerstone, yet and burying the innocents there, yet the checkerboard for that massive joke that the gods have now been replaced by the humanists. Most famous Freemason of them all, President George W. Washington, Rothschild was the father of the United States. Yeah, with the pyramid on his penis. Yeah, and the fish. Yeah, that is his penis in the Bible, and the loaves and fishes joke for the pisos. Yeah, and the fish might have come out of their pichon. Washington George, first president of the US, crossing the Delaware for the Dilla Warrens and the Warren Coppers, who could not solve the Piso Fanny crimes. Watson, Thomas John, self-made American, cannot have long to go till we get to Z. James Watt, my Harriet Watt University, right next door to the golf course, yeah, that I'm so fond of now because it's got the pacifist people that are the Earls of Morton living in it, and I'm talking to all of their employers, their employees now, and it's ever so interesting. They are the polo players on the Piso horse all across that Commonwealth that has been created and still belongs, yeah, to Her Royal Highness. What, the inventor of the steam engine and all of those warships and all of the Nazi vessels that they're able to fight against their own families with in the great conflicts, in all the great conflicts. There's the greatest Mason that ever lived, and he pined for Jesus when Telly Savalas had him executed on the cross on Calvary Hill, which is California, and the cavalry for him in Rothschild yellow and orange sectarian orange. Yeah, the greatest Mason of the lot. All the profiteering war crimes about the munitions that were the aircraft out of Washington, just to let them know it's Ash, that's Washington on the north by northwest face, where every one of the presidents is a link to the mafia, and two of them are direct links to the Rothschilds. Okay, and that is the Teddy Roosevelt joke again. Sorry, I got confused between Roosevelt and Ike Eisenhower and the Ike and Moses jokes that are Christian versus Jew in those great conflicts. All of them are Masons on the same side, entirely for profit, and they're kings and queens and presidents, and Hillary's the wrong gender to make it there. Yeah, her cat family is totally corrupted too. That is the genealogical crimes of the Rothschilds, Hitler Rothschilds, and King George the Seventh, the Orcafat one, who was the father of Winston Churchill, and Winston Churchill is the father of the Queen, and all of it is totally insipid and inbred, which is why the whole lot of them for generations got syphilis and the blue blood disease that is portrayed in the mad King George of Hanover, yet stealing of Britain. James Webb Space Telescope takes its name from the man who shaped NASA and the moon fake-ups, Freemason James Edwin Webb. The Weber jokes and the web of corruption that has led to globalism. Yeah, Webb, Captain Matthew. Captain Webb was the first man to swim the English Channel. All the sporting and explorers' feats that we admire so much in the Pie joke about Elizabeth Taylor and the life of Pie, and her mum being the first woman to swim the Channel. Yeah, the women are not allowed into the Masons or the presidency. Adam Weishaupt, the Rothschild's aide in Europe. Yeah, and the planning of all of the Freemasonic empire. Yeah, he's a big name in Freemasonry. German philosopher Adam Weishaupt, the order of the Illuminati, that's the pyramids for the pharaohs and for Mark Antony and all of the Roman linkages. Jonathan Adams, 1748 to 1830, German philosopher and free thinker. We've got 64 minutes up. I'm going to finish on time. I might be able to show you the wolves of Quebec the Order of the Illuminati in 1776 and attempted to combine the two. At its height, the Illuminati boasted among its members, that's in the past tense you might notice, Charles Augustus of Saxe-Weimar, Duke Ernest of Gotha, Saxe-Coburg and Gotha, Duke Ferdinand of Brunswick, Van Gogh, the devil author, and the man who is Gogh, played by the person who is the evil actor that is in the Schindler's List movie, and he is a relation of the American presidential aides that brought down the Twin Towers, and they're from Bedfordshire, yeah, where I had my first house, and it's totally owned by me before my wife moved in as a lodger. Herder and Pestazzoli among the other luminaries of the era. Yeah, so he has a bet with God, yeah, and he's the devil in that story. Okay, and his name is not Liam Neeson, it is, I can't remember, he's in the massive assassination in Bruges movie, which is a joke about Nick Clegg's wife in modern day times. Okay, Paul White's piloted the Skylab. Can you see how much mileage they get out of the swastika and St. Andrew's icon, even in their faked up stories about the stratosphere and how they can own the whole universe using these tactics? Don't worry too much about that, God's still totally in charge, but may not be able to prevent the nuclear extinction threat that Donald represents now. Yet with loads of support from his lookalike in London, Boris Johnson, with the man with the fifer, yeah, Eiffel Tower nicknames and his names in his middle names, like the new president's father, whose middle name was Christ. That's Fred Christ Trump, because they are the Aryan master race and they think they are more powerful than God. They have another think coming. Right then, we must be nearing the bottom, and here's all the space program jokes that we can now do it on a daily basis and come back without a splashdown and shooting the pooch, like the actor did in the Right Stuff movie, and he's the actor who shot the pooch in the Great Escape movie, and the real Steve McQueen died in his 40s, because you cannot make jokes like the Colditz jokes without being at risk, which is why several people that were in Colditz lost their limbs and became amputees before the end of the war or the end of their life, and that is the man that is the Scott Dukes of Buccleuch relatives that was had his legs crushed when he fell on his piezo horse. Yeah, no accidents anywhere in those stories. Yeah, nor was it an accident that those bombs were dropped on Pearl Harbor, and then the rocket scientists from the no-bombing regions were able to invent them to drop them on Japan, where the same fucking emperor still prevails. Samuel Wesley, nephew of John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist Protestant churches. Wentworth Charles was an Australian poet, explorer and politician. Let's get it finished. Wheeler, Jimmy Wheeler, Ernest Remnant, 1910 to 1970, comedian born in London, from 1928 a pioneer of radio performance from 1932 to the 1960s in the style of Jack Benny Wheeler, used a vi-vi violin as part of his act and would often parody famous operas. His catchphrase, I, the same as that as the assassin in the In Bruges movie, yet when the German gets shot in the eye because he fails to confront the profiteers. I wish I could remember his name. He's the one that makes the Hill and Hirsch selection, and he's Ralph Fiennes, yeah? Yeah, and it's the Fiennes of Bedfordshire, and they're related to Dick Cheney and all of the mobsters that brought down the Twin Towers to demonise Islam again, and that's the Shriners in all of their black and red fezzes, which is why the Red Fez Man, was taken down at the London Palladium, and he is Tommy Cooper. All the evil bloodlines that cull the Indians, Tommy Cooper, and the Coopers that are the launch of the Know-Nothings, and the movements that are the Putnam magazines that cover all of those great genocides with a total set of lies. Yeah, and they then become the Notting Hill sect and the Nottingham Forest revolutionaries, with the five arrows for Rothschild in their armoury. Paul Samuel Whiteman is famous for commissioning Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. Paul Robeson is the Robeson cover for the Robeson settlements on the Panama Canal. Yeah, the black man, all of them play the role of the slave, yeah, but they are quite happy to take the profit. Yeah, in the tar boy role, here's the one of the romantic poofs. Forget his name. Famous during his lifetime, an outstanding Irish writer and poet, Oscar Wilde, sadly died destitute in Paris at the age of 46. Yeah, all of them, the homosexual launch, and that is David Cameron's greatest achievement, that they can intermarry as poofs. Wilde, Oscar Fingland, O'Flaherty, Willis. Yeah, I got the name of the people that sing the Run Rabbit song wrong yesterday, and that is not the two that are the silent comedians, but it is actually Run Rabbit, and they are the covers of the Lovers of the Scots in my hometown that are they live in the town of Yetham, like Sheriff Peter Patterson, and they are the Flanagans, yeah, Flanagan and Alan, and the Alan joke is the Allah joke at the end of the day. All of it is totally trivial, and it leads to every one of those great conflicts to keep the numbers down and the wealth divide totally divided now. None of the central banks belongs to any of the countries of the world. All of them are in private hands. Wildman Mark, pool and TV commentator, snooker and pool commentator, all over the tellies yesterday, yeah, in the pubs that I was in. John Wilkes, an English radical politician, journalist, libertine, was first elected Member of Parliament in 1757. He was a pioneer and advocate of religious tolerance and freedom of the press, and they're still able to have the Shriners launching all of those wars in the Fezzes, and that is, for George Clooney, the black fezzes that were swimming past with the tambourines in the religious joke, and in that massive sectarian divide that is the use by every one of these cross-religious masons who keep their friends by paying a subscription, and at the end of the day it goes to the Duke of Westminster, who runs the British Legion for profit and the Poppy Fund. Yet used to be Butcher Haig, all of them are masons. Yet all of the modern ones, like the new president in America, will not reveal their lodge affiliation because it is so shocking that you're allowed to have secret societies like the SS that was demonized in Germany by the Aryan master race people at the time. Yeah, but now they are just the world's elites, and there's the Montague name that is the Duke of Buccleuch, and that's Sarah Montague, the propagandist. This one's associated, like Donald, with the golf course at Sandwich. Yeah, and here's the massive German Hanover linkage that means that Britain can never be free, and that's the Salic laws, and he's got the sword with the Christian cross on the top, and they've got all of the red flag jokes for the ambulance service that is launched out of Switzerland and still used to demonise, and there is Windsor Castle, yeah, built by the Germans, yeah, and owned by the Germans when they were in Gallipoli fighting against us, yeah, on the deck chairs so that they could have a good time watching the brutalisation of all of the Anzac war dead. Now, in Her Royal Highness's Connolly, that's a deliberate slip of the tongue, King William the Fourth, the sectarian William of Orange laughs, yeah, and the Freemasons into Ireland and eventually into Scotland. William Henry, King of Britain, Ireland and Hanover, 1765 to 1837. During his short reign, William IV made a better monarch than had been anticipated. 1830 to 37, he did much to heal the rift between America and Britain, and also assisted the passing of several groundbreaking acts of Parliament, the Factory Act, Preventing Child Labour, the Abolition Act, yet the abolition of slavery. All of them get remunerated for that, and that's the slaving towns of Liverpool and Bristol, and the links to Scots, and the links to the Dukes of Northumberland, and the Percys, who were Perseus in the Roman court, and the colonies, and the poor laws, yeah, that were only changed in 1914 when people began to read and write in mass numbers, and that is what will bring them down eventually. Okay, King William IV was a fellow of the Royal Society of London. He was made a Mason in Pie Plymouth, because that's where the Pilgrim Fathers sailed from after coming out of Leiden in Holland, yeah, and moving down the Ermine Way to Plymouth. Yeah, and he's got the ermine on his shoulders, I'll bet he has. Huge. Oh, he's not maybe innocent of the religious crimes out of Protestant Germany, and all the sectarian violence in all those great 30 years and 100 years war. He was made a Mason in Plymouth. Wilson James Orangeman, James Wilson, along with Diamond Dan Winter and fellow Freemason James Sloan, yeah, the Sloan Rangers, founded the Orange Order in County Tyrone. Not a mistake that they are linked together with the Hanoverians. Wingate, Sir Francis Reginald, 1st Baron Wingate. Here's a picture. Not unlike Paul Wheelhouse, MSP, famous for his Jeeves and Worcester, P.G. Woodhouse. Yeah, all the jokes about Worcester and his Batman and manservant and rearing the pigs and fattening them up, and the pig killing and the demonization of Islam and all of the religious movements about the kosher things that the Israelis and the Islamics differ on is laughed at by Ali G. Yeah, and all of the sexual deviancy is laughed at by Ali G, and all of the gods now being the people that sniff their relatives' bottoms, because the god is now the dog in the joke. Ever since Renee and Georgia Magritte returned with their dog after the war, and David Bowie used to sing about walking his dog through Berlin, yeah, and the jungle pub that is in Berlin, that is the Jumanji joke, with the Japanese soldiers being still in the jungle way after the war was over. And nobody knows whether any of those stories are true. His stories are comedies. The lettuce is the soggy fanny. Yeah, all of the names of the actors in that, he's a massive profiteer in wartime, and he flits across between and lives in hotels like Donald now runs, and Donald's hotels, for sectarian violence reasons, are called the Taj Mahal. Okay, Bertie Wooster, scatterbrained. Second World War, Wodehouse become a wealthy man, but while living in the south of France, he was interned by the Nazis. Believe it if you like, it's the same as the Colditz story. Yeah, and all of his jokes about rearing the pigs and bringing up the pigs, yeah, they're in the Bristol region where the slaving was done from too. Yeah, and I've visited those places, yeah, and it's the Plum City joke. He became a naturalised citizen in the USA in 1955, known to his family and friends as Plum City Field McConnell. P.G. Woodhouse was a golfing nut. One of his many quotes on golf was, the last thing upset him on the links, he missed short putts because of the uproar of the butterflies. in the adjoining meadows. He was a member of Jerusalem Lodge number 197, Ugly in London. Yeah, the Ugly Sisters in the stories about Krasnusy Elk and the Goose Woman and the fox that is after them all with the false news. Wolffe's of Donald